spirit and everything, but you know, we have a new week, new goals, new aspirations, so you know, we got a new mix that we got to get to get in tune for. So we're going ahead and I'm going to bring you out Marcus Boles. I know he's a new leader coming into the, new leader has been into the business for a little over a year now. He's making some great, excuse me, I'm sorry. He's making some great strides right now. So listen in and get in tune with what he got to say. And we all want to be good listeners this morning. So I want to bring you on to the call, Marcus Boles. Go ahead and take the floor.
Hey, sir, can you hear me? Hey, good morning. You can hear me? All right. Definitely want to say thank you for doing a roll call and definitely being a leader in this business and staying until you're getting your pay. I definitely know you have some great goals leading into 2014. We definitely can't wait to see you do great things. Today is Monday. Monday, December 9th, so we're about 3 weeks out now from the end of the year. But before we get started, I'm going to go ahead and put this thing in lecture mode.
All callers are muted and they can unmute themselves.
All right. Make sure we have our background noise muted. But definitely want to just say thank you for everybody checking in. Thank you for sticking and staying with the company until you get your pay. And the title for this morning's topic is actually just being grateful. Just being grateful. So before I jump into the actual message or what we're going to be talking about, just want to always open up with a quick prayer. So if you're not driving, please bow your head for a brief second. Dear Lord, thank you for waking us up on yet another great, awesome week. Thank you for allowing us to gather this morning and to just receive a message that you've placed on one of your son's heart and allow someone to take this message and predict it and go out and work it in the world, Lord. So we just thank you again for the opportunity that you've given us. In your son, Jesus Christ, and we pray in love. Amen and amen. All right, so again, the topic of this morning is just being grateful. Being grateful is actually something that I think a lot of people take for granted. It's just simply being grateful for the things that they have in their life. You know, a lot of people all the time want to focus on the things that they don't have, the things that they're striving to, the things that they're working towards, but they're sometimes forget about the simple grateful things they have in life. So I'm going to talk about two sides. I'm going to talk about the things you should be grateful just in life, and then the things you should be grateful for in your business, and then close it out with a small faith statement. So the first thing you should be grateful for is that you are able to just talk. Just talk. Now, there's some people in this world that are not able to speak. They don't even know what sound sounds like. So we take that small advantage of things just being able to talk, which is key in our business. But just think if you were not able to communicate or just hear yourself speak. You know, think of, you know, people that are deaf or that are mutes that can't speak. That is a characteristic trait that a lot of us take for granted, that we're able to use our words, because we know words are very powerful and they can touch a lot of people. So the first thing, again, that you want to be grateful for is that you're able to talk. The second thing is that you're able to walk, that you're able to wake up in the morning, use your own legs, not needing assistance from other means of getting around or not having anyone to help you get out of bed. That is something very, very powerful. Just think if you were not able to walk. You know, you think that you have a hard time in this business, you know, getting in your car, driving down the street to a PBR or to a BOM or to an event or wherever you're going, and you're like, man, this is hard. Just think about some people that can't even walk or can't even, or that are paralyzed and that can't do just that simple thing. That's the second thing you should be grateful for, that you're able to walk, you're able to move on your own power, and God has given you the ability to make that choice and that decision on your own, and you don't have to depend on anybody. The third thing that you should be thankful for is that you're able to think. Just think about all the thoughts that you think about each and every day. Just think about all the thoughts that you thought about in 2013. And the thoughts that you're thinking about for 2014, and then collectively the thoughts that you've had over your life. that's a lot of thinking going on. And just think, if someone controlled your thought process, if someone said, "Hey, you have to think about this at this time and on this day," that is something that we take for granted, and you should be thankful for that. God has given your own power and your own ability to make your future and your legacy for yourself, because He's given you the power to think. So definitely be grateful for that. The fourth thing that you should be thankful for is having a roof over your head. There are a lot of people, you know, I live in the city of Memphis, and I go downtown on Beale Street, and there's people sleep standing up. There's people sleep sitting outside in front of buildings, under bridges, in parks, in front of other establishments, because they don't have a roof over their head. They don't have a home. You know, we struggle, you know, talk about, hey, you know, well, I'm, you know, being IMR or ET or ED or ND for X amount of time. Just think about, if you didn't have a roof over your head, the last thing you would be thinking about is being ND, ED, SVP, whatever. So you definitely want to be thankful and be grateful that you have a roof over your head. And that's also connected to having food on your table. Just thinking that those people that are homeless may not even have food to put in their bodies, which is not the good nutritions. And National Director Jason Harris is doing a great series on that. And, you know, one of the things is eating a healthy breakfast. Some of those people go 2-3 days without eating, and the only thing they survive on is just water. So definitely don't take for granted, and you want to be grateful that you're able to just have these necessities of life. The next thing you want to be grateful for is that you're educated. There are some people that you know, we read the history books that were not able to be educated, that couldn't necessarily probably think for themselves because they wasn't educated. But you're educated enough here in today's society, and now, you know, that's one of the great things that America makes sure you have to do to be an American citizen is at least graduate high school. So be grateful that you're being educated and you've been giving most of the tools that you need to be successful. Now, we know that everything is not, you know, provided for everyone. You know, you have to go out in the world and get some of the things that, you know, that we're accomplishing now. But be thankful that you are educated. Someone took the time out to make sure that you went to school, or that you went to college, or however you got your education. Be grateful that someone took the time to invest in you to make sure that you can at least read, write, and understand, you know, simple things that are going on in the world, and then making a great future for yourself. And then the last thing you should be grateful for, just in general, is having a vision. Just having a vision. Most of the people that are on this line have a vision, because we've all been told, "Hey, that thing isn't gonna work. You know, what are you doing? You know, I don't get why you're, you know, want to go to college. I don't get why you're trying to move to another city or another state, or why are you going to this event, or why can't you, you know, spend time here or do this?" You have a vision. God has placed a vision in your head, and it's really His vision, and you're maximizing and fulfilling it. So definitely be grateful that you're able to see where you're going, and then that you're also able to look back as check marks and make sure that you're doing the right things. So that's what you should be grateful for just in everyday life. So now I want to switch over into the business. What are the great things that you should be grateful for just in five links? First of all, this opportunity. The first thing you should be grateful for about your business is the opportunity to even be in this business. Because there are a lot of people looking for five links but don't know how to get involved with it. There are a lot of people looking to do something different that are struggling, that are sick and tired of being sick and tired, but they don't know anything else to do. I was watching a movie over the weekend. I think it was called Attack on Wall Street, but the gentleman, he was a hard-working security guard. He did he drove a money truck, and his wife was sick. I'm not for sure what what she had, but she had to go to the doctor every week or every 2 weeks and get a shot, and each shot was $300. And then, you know, it was based around the time where Wall Street, a lot of people lost their money, and he lost all of his retirement and, you know, 401k and his investment. I think it was about $50,000 that he lost because, you know, the stock market pretty much plummeted. And so he was looking for something, but, you know, the only thing he knew to do was keep driving the security truck. Eventually, his wife had to, you know, stop going to get her treatment. The credit card people were calling. The bank were calling because he lost everything. So he was looking for an opportunity. He was so desperate that he actually, you know, attacked people on Wall Street. He started shooting people. So there are people that are going through some rough patches in their life, and their backs are up against a wall, and they're looking for the opportunity. But the people on this line and the people in your downline are blessed to have this opportunity. So definitely don't take that for granted. Be grateful that you're in this thing, and that the compensation plan is allowing you to develop growth and to, you know, to move on. And again, this is a 3-year vehicle, 3-year ride. So just because, you know, you've been in it 6 months, a year, or 2 years, and you may not hit all the goals, just be thankful that you have this opportunity to say that you're a part of Files, because a lot of people cannot say that and are not provided with the awesome training and information that we have. So the second thing that you want to be grateful for in this company, in this opportunity, is the positive mentors and leaders that you have connected with you. National Director Jason Harris is a true visionary. I'm so grateful for being connected with him, because without him sitting in that business finance class with me, I'm not for sure what I'd be doing right now. I'm not for sure if I even really be in Files. He had a vision to, you know, put this call together. Platinum Senior Vice President John Jones had a vision to put the international call together with William Fawcett. You know, the founders and co-founders just had a vision to create this awesome company. And then you also have, you know, your other leaders that, you know, put the regionals together, that do all these great things, that, you know, the Files University training, all that stuff came from people just like me and you. But be thankful that, you know, you're able to say that, hey, I can call these millionaires or these super successful people my mentors and my leaders, and I can send them a message on Facebook, and, you know, pretty much at a drop of a dime, if I wanted them to get here and do a BOM or do a presentation, I could, and they would. That is awesome to have, because there's a lot of people that do a lot of work in a lot of corporate America and other companies that can't say that. You know, the people that are leading are like ghosts. They're like ghosts. There's nothing wrong with leading from behind the scenes, but, you know, we can get to our leaders. A lot of people can't. So definitely be grateful that you're connected with positive leaders that are doing great things, not only just in this business, but a lot of our leaders are doing a lot of great things in the community. And that's what you want to see in a mentor and a leader. So the next thing that you want to be thankful for or grateful for is that you're connected with a positive team, that you're able to, you know, call on people. You know, if something happens, you know, in your personal life, you can talk to them about it. If something is happening in your business, you can call them and, you know, get their experience to see if they've been going through it, or get some wisdom and advice. Or, you know, you can call a family or a teammate down in another city because you're coming to a regionals, and they'll give you a place to sleep, you know, without having to pay hotel charges. So you want to be thankful that you're connected with a positive team, because there's some people in Files, there's some teams in Files that you can't do that. And you know, the Ready Group and the Millionaires and the Legacy Group, or however you want to look at it, we have an awesome team. We have an awesome team because we really operate as a family. We're really there for one another. And like I said, there's a lot of teams in Files that you cannot do it, because people are in this thing for themselves. And we know that serving and helping others is the best way to become successful, not only just in Files, but in life and being successful in general. So the last thing that you should really be thankful for is the growth and development that this company is instilling into you. I mean, Robert Kiyosaki for $119, and then also you're able to party. I think that they rented the beach out, so the private beach on Nikki Beach. That's crazy, guys. That's a crazy price, and you got to be grateful and cannot take for advantage that, you know, $119. I mean, that's a lot right around that. $119 compared to what? Compared to you still sitting here and not being trained by a best-selling author that is pouring his heart out to you of his 20, 30 years of experience of how to be successful, Take that and be grateful for it. Also, Darren Hardy was at the past two nationals. Take that and be grateful. These are people that not necessarily have the secrets to being successful, but just have the right information and connected to the right people and have gathered the right information from the people that have passed. Darren Hardy is a protege of a great man. Of a great man, and he gets a lot of his materials from a lot of successful people. I mean, talking about Bill Gates, he got information from him. Steve Jobs before he died, but most importantly, Jim Rohn. He was Jim Rohn's personal protege. He mentored Darren Hardy almost into the person that he is today. He talks about it all the time in his training. So if you're not connected with him and connected with his free material, definitely do that, because a lot of his material is free. If you just sign up, he'll subscribe and send you stuff all the time, playbacks, PowerPoints of what he's done. So definitely do not take for granted and be grateful for all of the personal development and growth that the company is pouring into us over each and every day. The corporate communique, all the back office stuff, the weekly top five or hot five, the company co-founder address, just all this great stuff, guys. We have got to be grateful, and when you're being grateful, that is the key to success. Gratefulness is the key to success, whether you want to believe it or not. Because if you're grateful, that means you're humble. And humble is also a key to success. So I just want to leave you guys with this faith statement. The training is going to be very short and sweet, to the point, because again, we're leading into the last 3 weeks of the year. So I want everyone to really be working on this Monday instead of, you know, listening to me. But take this information and share it. I'll have it up on Facebook and YouTube by the end of the day. So take it and share it with someone. But I want to leave you with this quote, and then we can open up the line for Q&A. Now just listen to this. You must believe this is what you want. You must believe this is what you want. Faith is now, hope is tomorrow, but faith is now. You have to believe that you are blessed now, you have to believe that you have it now, and you have to believe that you're successful now. You have to believe that you're growing now, and you have to believe that you are living a first-class lifestyle now. Again, I'm going to say it. You have to have faith, which is now, but hope is tomorrow, and faith is now. Powerful words for a Monday morning. So, the time is 7:50. Press *6 if you have any questions or want to make a comment. National directors and executive directors, the line is already live for you.
Executive Director Marcus Boles, can you hear me?
Absolutely. National Director Jason Harris, extraordinary. Take it away.
Man, that was an awesome training. I really appreciate you just really breaking down all the things to be grateful for, not just in this business, but just in life. And, man, you touched on a lot of key things, man. I don't really want to take up too much time, but I just wanted to give it up to you. And I was watching a video about Robert Kiyosaki with the great Oprah Winfrey. And one of the things he was saying, that you want to be grateful and you also want to pay yourself first. A lot of us, we pay our bills first. He said that's what the poor do. The poor pay their bills first. The wealthy pay themselves first and use the collectors and people who asking for the money as motivation to keep pushing and work harder. So definitely pay yourself first, and man, be grateful for what you got. So appreciate you for this training.
Man, definitely thank you for the enhancement. But that is true. That is true. Definitely thank you again, just being a leader, visionary, and again, I'm grateful for you, and I thank God that you are in my life, and I'm able to be connected with you. Do we have anyone else?
Executive Director Marcus Bowles.
Yes, ma'am. Miss National Director Extraordinary. Also, Miss Nidra Reddy, take it away. The call is yours.
Good morning. Yes, sir. I am just sitting here. here, you know, just really embracing the words as you're giving them out. A lot of golden nuggets, most certainly nothing new, but reinforcement, particularly for this time of the year, is very, very welcome. Being grateful, you know, as you were talking about the gratefulness of a person just being able to walk, I was reminded of this past regional. I had a representative in Dallas, Texas, who also wanted to get to the event, and she has special physical limitations confined to a wheelchair, and she took her assistant, this company who provides transportation, took her to this train line to the, she was making her route to the regional, and got halfway there, and they missed the second connection for a train in Dallas, and unfortunately she didn't make it to the event, and she was so upset. And of course, you know, I kept, you know, sharing information with her along the way, and encouraged her to not give up on Five Links, not give up on life. And, you know, so as you were saying that, I was just thinking about how there are those of us who don't need the assistance of equipment or others to help us move to and fro from our, you know, daily walk. And then there are those who can't get where they want to because of their physical limitations, and we don't even take the opportunity that God has given us to just get up and walk and go and do what we know we need to be doing. And, I'm just really sitting over here just moved by the idea that this conversation is so very timely, because just this time of the year, just being the holiday season, begins to make people start to question. And in the end of the year, you know, this season makes people begin to question whether or not they are where they ought to be, and began to comparing themselves. And particularly for my colleagues who spend a lot of time on Facebook, sometimes I keep hearing from people and it makes them, you know, feel depressed because they compare themselves to what someone is saying on Facebook. And that's always interesting to me, because really we should just be grateful, as you say, and we really need to quit trying to compare ourselves with others. We really just need to look inward and be grateful to God that if you're able to get up and dial a telephone number and listen to a call and make a comment, that is an amazing gift from God. And I'll tell you this, and I'll end with this in the interest of time, but you know what? I know personally, and I'm speaking just as a personal mother, wife, sister, niece, aunt, grandmother, you know, just to wake up and breathe on your own without equipment. We're at a time right now where so many things are going on in our lives, and a lot of, even today, students cannot go to school because of the snow and ice on the ground. So we should just be grateful just for each day. We have to take every day and just, that's why God called it the present. We should just be grateful just to be able to get up and wake up. And everybody has a responsibility to go out and make the world better than you found it yesterday when you lay down and went to sleep. Mr. Marcus Boles, I turn the call back over to you. Thank you for the message on being grateful.
Well, I definitely absolutely appreciate those kind words, and coming from a woman of experience, I just thank you, and my ears perk up each and every time you begin to speak, because you've seen a lot, and just for me to be able to give a message and know that someone with wisdom agrees with it, my day is already shining. So definitely thank you. Do we have anyone else? Press *6. To unmute your line before we close out on the Monday morning. All right. Well, guys, as I always say, I love everyone. I thank you that you're connected with me. I thank you that you're connected with the Millionaires Club, and that you're connected in Five Links, and that God is doing great things in your life, and that you're touching people. As I always end, if you hang around millionaires, you start to look like them. You keep hanging around and you start to act like them. And if you stick and stay with them, you get bank accounts and lifestyles like them. Again, guys, I love you. See you guys tomorrow, but take this week by storm and be grateful.